74. What?
995.
995. And that makes your budget go up by?
178, no, 175. 173. 173, 803. Okay, do we need to revisit?
I'll make the motion to approve that.
Did you get that, the line of that line?
173, 803.
I second it, I do.
Okay, call the roll.
Russell Reed?
Yes.
Corey Davenport?
Yes.
Karen Ashford?
Yes.
Jim Bush?
Yes.
Greg Mitchell?
Yes.
Brent Brandon?
Yes.
Randy Gannon?
Yes.
Kim Davenport?
Yes.
Ronnie Mahaffey?
Yes.
So, all I have in the general fund, I think we'll just say we'll be good with debt service, right? Is that page 31, highway funds? Page 31, we do that instead of general fund? I'm on the original budget, has anything been turned in different from the, on page 31, 32?
33, 34. Yeah, 34 is the final page. And we do 34, 39. Down in our route, $15, so we give it. The rest is, yeah, tax. We'll cash by, get it, Kim.
No.
We'll just get certain percent.
You get a percent. No matter where you buy, then the state has a form where they go by, they still, $275,000.
They still have our businesses up.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
We get the sales tax.
I'll make the motion to approve that, but.
Second.
What's the actual number on that budget?
$4,314,902.
Yeah, but it'd be like, what's their budget number? Yeah, there's.
Oh, sorry.
What are they, Clark's number?
Public Works, 131, highway, Public Works, 131.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, I got a second, I got a first, a second, I got a, any discussion? All right, call the roll.
Russell Reed?
Yes.
Corey Davenport?
Yes.
Karen Ashford?
Yes.
Jim Bush?
Yes.
Greg Mitchell?
Yes.
Brent Brandon?
Yes.
Randy Gannon?
Yes.
Kim Davenport?
Yes.
Ronnie Mahaffey?
I know we all noticed that his reserves took a huge hit, with a million down to $443,000. It's overspending by $642,897. I don't think it has anything to do with it, to be honest with you. I think it has to do with some expenditures, but anyway, with all that being said, I guess we got faith that Wayne's got that control. Otherwise, disaster's looming.
Yeah.
Yep, so we're down.
Yes?
Oh, sorry, yeah, I got faith in him.
Okay, we've already sent back the schools. Debt service. I'm on page 44. Now, section, general debt service fund, 151, it gets a, half a cent.
I
cut just for her.
I said that half a cent is what Bonnie has proposed.
Correct. What's he getting right now? Getting anything different?
Yeah, half of it, half.
That's what I, half of that.
Well, I'd put 4 cents with it. Correct, Diane?
Do what?
I'd put 4 cents over the pothead.
Not according to this.
$1.05.
Well.
I'd put 4 cents. From sanitation.
Didn't put.
No.
Oh, I apologize.
General debt service. Oh, I know what you're saying. You took 4 cents away from solid waste and moved it over to debt service?
Yeah.
We, I don't think.
That's all the proposal you got, man.
Okay, well, yeah, I put 4 cents.
I think you just cut it.
Yeah, I think you just cut it. You didn't, I don't think.
You didn't.
No, it was to go over there.
I'm sure it's going to be, but not on the debt service, you put half a cent there.
Well, I intended to put, because I cut the ambulance by 1 cent, but put the .005 back in the ambulance, so that's a fraction less than 1%. And then I took the four that I take away from sanitation and thought I'd put it into the .005. Get it where the revenue, annual revenue, would exceed annual expenditure.
Did not tell me that.
Okay, I apologize. But that's where the mind was at.
You can see where, well, in actual 2017-18, we actually had, I did the math on that, competing at that time, property charges, what, $20,000 on average, but there's your property tax.
Where are you at?
I'm on page 44, right there, top, 4110, fourth line, current property tax. Bronny was talking about how much money, and of course, the current property levy is projected at $125,070. That's kind of what we're talking about, property levy, let's see, that way you can see the numbers.
Okay, the half cent is there, because it was .005.
Right.
And I put 4 cents in along with the other to get it from the ambulance to get it to .005. It's 5 cents. So that is reflected, 5 cents. It was .005.
We took some out last year, but what was it before then? Plus, I can say.
We got the same thing, I have some.
Yeah.
So you.
So we buy a park trucks.
That's what they buy.
Well,
We buy one and then the two park department bought two. Oh, right.
Yeah, it was .005 between the ambulance, the list of the penny and the four. It's 5 cents between here versus .005.
It's 5 cents.
Exactly, yes, sir. So it does reflect bringing over pennies.
Yeah, the metal, you multiply it out by metal, it comes up like on the paper.
Yeah, it's 5 cents.
Well, I guess your logic was, it was, if you look at your total revenue, it's sitting at $207,000. Total expenditures are $159,900, it keeps it low.
We're just trying to cover the annual.
Yeah.
That's just, you know.
Because you have annual principal notes, $47,000, interest on notes, $8,400. You got trustee commission in there for $4,500. Then you got transfer to education debt service for $100,000. That's the business within the fund, so.
And coming out with $47,000, four savings, positive cash flow.
Beautiful.
For two days education debt service. Is that $100,000 on payback every year?
Yeah.
I personally would like to take a little penny out of solid waste and put 6 cents into debt service. But that's just not, I'd like to see for the,
there's a little different debt service account. It's not designed to build up capital outlay. It's designed to build up finance and fire. This one's designed for, this one's services.
Yeah, correct.
So pays or makes.
Pays or makes a payment. So I understand what you're trying to say. You want to build up and take away the solid waste, but you want to buy something, use that as a down payment rather than do it. You still have to kind of take the transfer itself.
This is,
yeah. this is debt to pay debt.
What was it last year?
Half a percent. Basically, the thing, you brought in only $10,000, or we brought in $10,316. You got other things too, now you brought in some trustee collections, circuit court, interest penalty about $1,599, litigation tax, jail $7,000, bank excise tax.
So we brought in last year $34,000?
Well, it brought in, if you go back to the actual year before, 17-18 budget, you brought in there $463,466. Last year, currently this year, this last June 30th, this past June 30th, you brought in $97,793. This is a proposal that sits in double that.
What was your expenditure, year's $234,87?
We get our hundred, our total expenditure at $155,635, very bottom thing.
For this year?
Yeah, and so, but the previous year it was $3,055, this last year. Previous year was $335,728, and it was probably due to the fact we retired the debt here at $140,000, and $8,000, so we retired some debt out of that account.
So what have we got going out there?
Oh, you're talking about, oh, you're, he's wanting to know the debt, projected debt.
There's still be a remodel, another one to deal.
I thought the litigation tax had that. But that's.
Litigation tax is revenue. Well, the projection, the total expenditures for this next year is $199,900. You got a principal note there for $47,000. You got another one, interest on the note, $8,400. And you got another, so there's your, and then of course the $100,000 for education debt service. That's $159,900. And that's what we're saying. It's essentially, to me, it's $40,000 to the good.
And you're also bringing in $8,541 from the 911 center. Pay back on the loan that paid off years ago, that they're still paying the county back for.
Any other discussion?
Does it make sense to hold up on this one until we take a look at the big picture of?
Sure, you can do that. That's a good suggestion. Y'all hold on this one to see, because actually you're leading me into Greg Segway. By my, we're back over here and basically I'm on page 6, and I was just kind of looking at the change and jumping. On page 6, that's kind of where we got to get to then. We got to go through the rate, general fund, solid waste, general purpose schools. The change I have right now is definitely there's a change in that rate of 131 for the general fund. I think school is still sitting at 0.685. And I think the change for the ambulance service is not 0.2189. I think it's 0.223. Am I wrong on that?
2239.
That's what I had. 223. So we got to come up with go through the general fund and see what that actual property rate number is for 131. Diane, do you have that math from?
Yeah.
What's the total? What do you think?
$383 that we're going into fund balance. $5,500.
So that would make that not 131, that would make that
238 plus.
But I'm saying though, you got to actual work it out with the general fund.
Yeah.
So we're adding 16 cents to the general fund, not 50.
15.29 is what that equals.
Well,
it looks like 16. Means zero.
$1.47. So the proposed, property levy is 147 for the general fund, .12 for solid waste. Well, I'm on page six, sorry. .12, 12 cents. Then you got general purpose schools, it's .685. General debt service, again, y'all got a question mark of that, y'all want to see, let's go to .5 in. Then you got ambulance services at .2239.
So what'd you say, 147?
147.
So next to the health, big one, you got that? 6.548.
2.5489? 489 or 589?
489.
I have 2.5489. Is that right, Diane?
3, that's right.
Yeah.
2534. That was 15.2. Correct, it's, a wash. Did I say that?
Yes, you did.
What was I saying? Okay, okay, yeah, it does not increase, let me literally put that, it does not increase the general fund, how about that?
What is the general fund, the solid waste, still, I mean, not a pure general?
Well, that's part of the general.
Part of the general.
Part of the general.
I'm gonna put this out there. Y'all can think about it. Well, go ahead, Darrell, I want you to listen to this. The approval of the sheriff and the jail budgets, which, we got to have that, and we're gonna do the hiring of the deputies and all your personnel. And, you know, and it was mentioned that, you know, if, as far as your clerical and all other people, if they could, if you could delay their raises until the money kind of comes in some, I'm just asking a question. Your clerical.
They gonna walk out?
No, I just asked a question.
You mean just give it all this time?
Huh?
You mean till it comes in the general fund?
Yeah.
Is that what you mean?
Right.
You're basically trying to avoid a transfer.
Right.
So you're saying it'd be retro, then? It would retro back if he's late?
Well.
Is that what you?
Either way.
You get the money come in the general fund.
Just wouldn't do it until the end of the year. That's what he said, unless I'm telling you.
So, I mean.
$218,000.
Right.
What we have in the, we're gonna have a cash, we're gonna have a cash flow crunch here in a quick minute.
That retroactive back to July 1?
Do what now?
Will that be retroactive back to July 1?
Could be. Well, I mean, that's what, you know, that's what you say sometimes, though. Yeah, it would be retroactive.
I
But I can read it. Okay. Now.
Well, maybe the great chance of leaving.
All right.
I would still want to check. We can't do a portion of this budget anyway. We can't do the 911 contribution, because we don't have enough money in the general fund.
Right.
We're projected to be at $212,107 at the end of this month. We won't get there.
Or the contribution, all paid.
That's why I was like, what are we going to pay the contribution?
They usually put the end of the year.
So we don't have to pay it here until next June, May?
Really, we just wait till we have it.
Okay, that's good.
Now, but, you know, so all the departments go back to the last year's budget, of 18-19 budget, or 19-20, whichever one's latest, okay? Except mandatory department head increases that the state mandates. All right, we got to find the finance director and department of expenditures. Also, the additional employees of the circuit court clerk's office and the county clerk's office. And then expense to update the computer systems. And insurance, a $400 contribution to each of the county employees participating in the group health. Now, if we do this, it will help our financial structure. So, I mean, it's up to you. And basically, this is as far as I can think.
Realize what you're going to do with their tax rate, you pay all that back to the year.
You know, that's just like you go somewhere and they offer you a bonus instead of a pay raise, or especially for union. The union takes their portion, federal government takes their portion, you might have that.
Pretty much gone back to last year's budget.
Do what?
It's pretty much gone back to last year's budget for a lot.
Well, in some cases.
Yeah, a lot of numbers are decisions.
And there's some we have.
Dana? Depends on how you look at it. I mean.
Well, like I said, if you go back and you use 18-19, and you do your 19-20, whichever one's less, that's what we go with. You know, we do a substantial increase to the library. Made on that. So, it's just something to consider. I'll put it up there.
And Dan, I apologize, but did you say we want to make those contributions at the end of the fiscal year?
Yeah.
Whenever we got the money, that's it.
They might put two more, a 911, it's going to rot in a hard place.
We wouldn't be able to do 911 that way. We need to reimburse the money. That's what they did for us, but we need to pay our license to check it.
So we pay that on a monthly basis?
But we've never done this before. On the 911. Whatever we think that we need to do.
So Kim, what are you saying? Boston keeps raising and everybody else pound thing till the end of the year.
That means on what department you're in.
Yeah. I mean, there's things that we have to do and there's things we don't.
I agree with that.
Okay, so.
I'm going to look cloudy on something.
But we don't have to put everybody back.
I mean, that's fine.
We're going to go back to the zero or the same budget they had. It's going to be across the board to make it fair.
That's up to y'all. I just put it out there. Well, that'll have to make the numbers work. If you don't, then you're gonna have a tax increase. So, one of the two.
I'd just say from the fair standpoint, and I appreciate Cory, we already recognize we're not being fair across the board.
So we're gonna make it unfair again?
No, two wrongs don't make a right, but you do the best you can from a priority standpoint.
As far as how much money you got.
From the sheriff and the jail standpoint, that's your number one priority in this county. Hands down, no department comes close to it.
I don't disagree, I'm not arguing that.
You know, hindsight's always 20/20, but boy, we sure should have started with this budget. I think it would put us in perspective of really what our financial shape was going forward. But since we did, we came back up and cut, so, you know, we have to.
What I'm saying is, though, is if we're going to go back to the original budgets of last year, other than the state mandated rates, that should be across the board. We shouldn't differentiate between one department and another.
Well, and yet.
I mean, how is it fair that, and I voted to put the money in there, so I'm not saying I want to take it out, I'm saying, how is it fair that we put $25,000 in certain court, but we don't give anybody else anything?
Well, and again, I agree with everything you're saying, just from a state standpoint, that's all it is. That was the employee they had, so it's replacing the employee that they did have. It's not pay increase, it's actually replacing the employee they had.
Sandy did the same thing in the registrar's office.
Well, but that's being taken away. If you go back with that logic, you would not get that $4,000, whatever.
That's my point, though, she's doing the same thing with Katina, replacing money.
Then I misunderstood, because from Katina's standpoint, my understanding was we're actually giving her back the employee we took away 2 years ago. Whereas in Sandy's standpoint, to my knowledge, that restricted was salaries. It was not the employee. Employee less plus one minus, when it was restricted to salary.
Am I wrong? Katina not have same amount of employees she had last?
Same amount, same amount.
You're not giving another employee.
No, but Katina doesn't have the same employees going 2 years back. We actually replaced the employee 2 years ago, not last fiscal year.
Well, she's always had.
She's got the same amount of people she's always had. They just cut her back.
So, okay, then I misunderstood. I honestly thought we replaced the employee.
We are.
In the circuit court.
That's better budget to try to force her to get rid of it.
That's correct.
And she did.
And she did not. She has the same amount of people she's always had.
I stand corrected. Appreciate y'all sharing.
I mean, I'm not, you can ask her, but.
And I'm fighting forward. I think, I'm not trying to take anything away, I'm just saying, when you look at it from the apples to apples.
No, that is apples to apples. And what's good for the goose is good for the gander.
That's kind of what I'm saying.
And Cory, I'm honest, I agree with you. Debate, that's where you go. Try to be as fair as you can.
Yeah, because I actually think what she's got is she's got a full-time person that's working for part-time payment.
Yeah.
It's basically what she got.
See, they were willing to take that cut.
They were willing to stay and take that cut.
Well, I just misunderstood, so I'm saying.
Wrong. I don't think it's wrong because my pay is still working.
No, I don't either. That was done before the main security, that was signed illegally.
No, I'm trying to be as fair as I possibly can, so I can look county employee in the eyes and tell them, you know, I voted this way before.
That's kind of where I'm at. But now, we're leaving opinion half too by funding for, and I know the argument is that we're fully funded, but the finance director, we ain't got it, we're fully funded, and that's close to opinion right there.
Math is absolutely correct, but I agree with Greg and what you keep saying, I just keep reminding myself today is, you want as clear a picture as you can going forward. We know that expense is on the table. And to massage the numbers to make it work this year, we just know we pay the price.
Well, I get it, I'm not saying that I don't.
We don't know that, we don't, and saying too, I keep thinking about, we don't know if that's a true number.
No, we don't.
That we've got, this is new.
You're right, we still, all ten of us have to answer to the taxpayers when it comes down to them asking me, why did you fully fund a department when you don't even have anybody in there? And I have to raise their taxes because of.
And you're going to next year.
Yeah, but they're gonna pay it this year when they don't have to.
And the taxpayers want